morning and a very warm welcome. You're watching Janata Television and this is the English Bulletin with me, Sushant Dhakal. The top stories first. Joint session of Federal Parliament to begin today. PM Deoba to seek vote of confidence. UML to unify party leaders on the basis of 10-point agreement. Entire rank and file of the party wants unity. Government confirms 1,875 new cases of coronavirus. KMC reports a surge in rate of infection. Daughter of Afghan envoy kidnapped in Pakistan. Afghanistan urges for security of diplomats. And Olympic Village test first COVID case days before Tokyo Games. Concern grows around the event's safety. And now the news in detail. The joint session of the Federal Parliament is beginning today as per the apex court verdict. A report.
President Bidya Devi Bhandari has summoned the joint session of Parliament for 4 p.m. today afternoon upon the recommendation of the new government. Speaker Agniprasad Sapkota stressed for unity among the political parties given the far-reaching significance of the reinstated Parliament from historical and multidimensional fronts. International community as well as national stakeholders have been closely observing the latest development following the reinstatement of the House of Representatives in the changed political scenario of the country. Prime Minister Sher Bahadur Deoba's future course of politics will be determined by the vote of confidence he receives from the parliamentary session. The Parliament Secretariat informed that all preparations are in place for the House session, with by adopting all recommended health protocols amid the risk of COVID-19 pandemic. Domestic politics of Nepal has entered a new course following the landmark verdict of the Supreme Court on July 12 against the dissolution of the House of Representatives. Executing the July 12 decision, the lower house has been reinstated and the government has been formed under the leadership of Nepali Congress President Sher Bahadur Deoba. The UML has 121 lawmakers, Nepali Congress 63, CPN 49 and Janata Samajwadi Party Nepal 34 lawmakers in the parliament. The Nepal Workers and Peasant Party, the Rashtriya Janamorcha and the Rashtriya Prajatantra Party each have one lawmakers, while Chakka Bahadur Lama is an independent lawmaker.
The second-rung leaders of CPN-UML are directing their efforts towards unifying the party on the basis of the 10-point agreement. Leaders representing KP Oli and Madhav Kumar Nepal reached this conclusion during a meeting held yesterday. Leaders present during the meeting held at Singhadarbar reached a conclusion to unify the disgruntled leaders of the party on the basis of the 10-point agreement made by the UML Dispute Resolution Task Force. Deputy Leader of the UML Parliamentary Party, Subhas Nembang, said a decision has been made to forge unity in the party by implementing the new agreement. The task force has already submitted the agreement to the party chair Oli and senior leader Nepal. The task force had forged the 10-point agreement for party unity on July 11th. Party Secretary Gokarnaraj Bista said the discussion had been held to save the party unity on the basis of the new agreement. He said that the entire party rank and file is concerned and wants the party to be intact. Nepali Congress has condemned the attack on the party's central member, Shyam Ghimire. Ghimire is also a member of the Active Membership Probe Committee of the party. Some party members attacked Ghimire, taking over the issue of the party's active membership on Friday. Issuing a statement yesterday, party spokesperson Vishwaprakash Sharma said this act, when Ghimire was busy with organizational tasks, does not exhibit the conduct of a disciplined cadre of the party. The meeting of the party office bearers and former office bearers held on Friday in the lead up to the upcoming 14th General Convention of the party also took serious note of the incident. stating that it is the duty of every level member of the party to support the job of the committee. Spokesperson Sharma in the statement said any act against the set procedure of grievances related to the membership will not be acceptable to the party. This is Janata Bulletin. We'll be right back after a short break. Welcome back. After the break, we continue with other national news. The government yesterday reported 1,875 new cases of COVID-19 across the country. The cases were confirmed from 10,066 tests, said the Ministry of Health and Population. According to the ministry, 630,407 infected people have recovered from the disease so far, following the discharge of 2,164 patients yesterday. Similarly, the death toll from the infection has hit 9,527, with 21 deaths reported yesterday. The number of active cases of coronavirus in the country currently stands at 25,952. Meanwhile, Kathmandu Metropolitan City has reported an increase in the rate of infection. The rate of infection, which had dropped to 9% a week ago, has increased to 11%. The recent surge in infection has been attributed to the relaxation in the restrictions by the government. And now the news from the economic front. Nepal has received ₹870.94 billion in remittance in the first 11 months of the last fiscal year. Remittance inflow increased by 12.6% to ₹642.14 billion in the review period, compared to 3.2% in the corresponding period of the previous year, according to the current macroeconomic and financial situation report of Nepal Rashtra Bank. The central bank said that the number of Nepali workers obtaining re-approval for foreign employment decreased by 47.1% in the review period. It had decreased by 31.1% in the same period of the previous year. The net transfer in the review period increased by 11.4% and reached ₹971 billion. This transfer had dropped by 3.9% in the corresponding period of the previous year. Time for a short break here at Janata Bulletin. Stay tuned for international news. Welcome back, and now the international news. The daughter of Afghanistan's ambassador to Pakistan was briefly kidnapped and injured by unknown assailants on Friday. According to the BBC, Silsila Ali Hill was held for several hours after being seized on her way home in the Pakistani capital, Islamabad. Afghanistan's foreign ministry says she was severely tortured and it was lodging a complaint. Relations between the two neighbors have long been strained. Pakistani officials says Silsila, who is in her 20s, was assaulted by assailants who got into a car she was traveling in and beat her up. After her release, she was treated in hospital. Condemning the inhuman attack, the ambassador, Najib Al-Khil, said his daughter feels better now. The Afghan Foreign Ministry expressed its deep concern and urged Pakistan to guarantee the safety of diplomats and their families. You're watching Janata Bulletin, and now the latest from the world of sports. The Tokyo Olympics has registered its first COVID-19 case in the Olympic Village 6 days before the Games open. Tokyo 2020 CEO Toshiro Mutu confirmed on Saturday that a visitor from abroad who is involved in organizing the Games had tested positive. He did not reveal the person's nationality, citing privacy concerns. According to Al Jazeera, the person has been removed from the village where thousands of athletes and officials will reside during the Games. Organizers have put in place stringent measures to avoid coronavirus infections in the village. People in Japan have been lukewarm about the Olympics amid resurgence in new coronavirus infections and worries that an influx of foreign visitors may help turn the Tokyo Olympics into a super spreader event. We are at the end of Janata Bulletin and the headlines once again. Joint session of Federal Parliament to begin today. PM Deuba to seek vote of confidence. UML to unify party leaders on the basis of 10-point agreement. Entire rank and file of the party wants unity. Government confirms 1,875 new cases of coronavirus. KMC reports a surge in rate of infection. Daughter of Afghan envoy kidnapped in Pakistan. Afghanistan urges for security of diplomats. And Olympic Village just first COVID case days before Tokyo Games. Concern grows around the event's safety. And that's all from the English News Desk for today. You can follow Janata Television and our programs on various social media platforms, including on our website, janatasamachar.com. Keep watching Janata Television. Namaste.